Philippine food and beverage kiosk operator Fruitas Holdings files for a 1.2 billion peso initial public offering. With us now for more is Calvin Chua, the Fruitas Holdings Inc.'s chief financial advisor. Good to have you with us, Calvin. Welcome to the program.
Good morning. Thank you for having us.
So Fruitas was among companies that shelved an IPO plan in 2018 because of a bear market. So what made the company decide that now is the time to list when the market is neither cheap nor expensive?
Well, when we looked at our growth strategy, growth plans, we thought that this would be an opportune time to share a story to the public, get new investors in, and also fund our short to medium term requirements.
So what's the story that you wanted to share to the public, and how has that changed from the time you really wanted to list last year and the time that you're listing now?
Well, for us, we are planning to grow 150 to 250 stores annually. A huge part of the proceeds will be used towards the store network expansion and store improvements. But also, we're looking at acquisitions and introduction of new concepts.
Talk to us about the IPO itself. Up to how much of this will be primary and secondary? And what will the percentage of ownership be for the founders once the company's listed?
Yeah, our base offer is up to a maximum of 534 million shares. And there's an over-allotment option of about 68 million shares. Assuming the base offer is maximized as well as the over-allotment option is exercised, there would be as much as 28.2% available for the public.
As this, yeah.
Go ahead.
And how much of an interest in the IPO are you seeing from local, foreign, and the retail market at this point?
Well, we are still in the review and regulatory approval stage, so we're still not in the selling stage. So, well, we are aware of what the analysts have been talking about regarding our IPO, but for us, we're still waiting for approvals.
What we do know is that this planned expansion is really for the whole Philippines. So what demand are you seeing for your food and beverages, and in which cities across the country outside the capital, Metro Manila?
It's across the Philippines. In fact, in 2018, if you look at our outlet sales for Vismin, and dig deep into our financial statements, it actually grew 150%. So we're looking at broad-based growth across the Philippines.
And this 150% growth happened even during the year that the sugar sweetened beverage tax came through? I mean, that didn't affect demand nor sales?
Well, the sugar sweetened beverage tax only affects a small portion of our revenues. It only affects bottled fruit juice, which is with sweeteners. And as you know, one of our strengths is really having a strong and broad brand portfolio. So, you know, it had little effect on us.
How little an effect, and what portion of the revenues? And are you considering to lessen the exposure to the bottled sugar sweetened drinks to have more revenues coming from the fresh fruit juices?
It hasn't been a major contributor to our revenues. So if you look at our different brands, of course we sell bottled fruit juices across several brands, but the one which has majority of its revenues from fruit juices would be Juice Avenue. And if you look at the revenues from last year, it's maybe 53 million. Which is a very small portion of our revenues last year.
Let's talk about those planned acquisitions. Do you have acquisition targets already in mind now that would make for a strategic fit for your company?
We are still in the early stages of evaluating these options. As you said, the key criteria for us would be strategic fit with our operations, something that would open up channels, that is, well, a prime example of which is Sabroso Lechon, which actually opened the institutional channel for us last year.
Talk to us about what sort of synergy did we see from Lechon and beverages?
Well, one is the institutional channel, so it's currently served in selected top hotels. It also taught us a lot about delivery. As you know, a lot of the Lechon is through delivery. So we're looking at similar acquisitions, similar targets that would add value to us.
So can we expect then that there will be more of this kind of alignment with institutionals rather than retail, or is it going to be a combination of both when you try to find that strategic fit between institutionals and retail?
Our medium-term plan still focuses on store network expansion. We're looking at adding 550 to 650 owned stores up to 2022. But of course, we will evaluate all of the different channels. Part of our strategy is diversifying our distribution channels.
All right. Well, all the best in the listing. Calvin Chua, thank you so much for the expounding there of the plans for Fruitas Holdings. CFO joining us from Rockwell.
Thank you.